Hey guys, so you built your sound system, you have a head unit, you have amplifiers, you got speakers, you got a sub, but you want more sound. Or maybe you're about to build your sound system, whether with an aftermarket head unit or a factory one, you want to get the best. Well, then comes the sound processor.
Today's product we're going to be looking at comes from Alpine. It's a PXA-H800 and the control unit for it, the RUX-C800. So this is what comes in the box. You have your manuals, the audio processor, of course, and any additional wiring or mounting hardware you need to do the actual install.
So without getting too techy, let's talk about why you need an audio processor and let's look at the unit itself. You can see here, you can hook up multiple devices to it in line. Here are your inputs, and here are your outputs. So now you know what goes in between your head unit, whether it be factory or aftermarket, and your amplifiers. But why do you need something like this? The main reason you need something like this is, as good as aftermarket head units are, they don't really replicate sound properly. Something like this, what this does is, it can actually compensate for the acoustics of the vehicle and then help you fine-tune the system to make the vehicle sound better. Especially when you're doing a factory head unit with an aftermarket system, you need an audio processor to make it sound good. Think of it this way, garbage in, garbage out. So if you have a garbage signal in, it's not going to come out that well because the amplifiers can't exactly fine-tune it the way something like this can. It's not just for audio files. This is really for anyone that wants to replicate sound accurately. Another neat accessory that the PXA-H800 comes with is this microphone. What this microphone allows you to do is install it into the vehicle, into your audio processor, allowing the audio processor to start tuning for the vehicle's acoustics inside the vehicle.
So what is road EQ? What road EQ does is it would intercept incoming road noise coming from the tires, for example, and getting the speakers to generate an opposite frequency relative to that to cancel it out. You might find this apparent when you hook up subs backwards when they're out of phase. One's going forwards, the other's going backwards, and you have no bass. Kind of the same idea. I'm going to make a little demonstration here because, quite frankly, I can't afford to pay someone to do it in CG. So we're just going to use some water. So, as you see, if I were to make a ripple in the water, kind of similar to a sound wave. So what we're going to do is, let's just pretend that this is road noise, those little waves coming out. Here's the road EQ. So what the road EQ does is, you'll have two opposite waves coming at each other, canceling them out, giving you a nice, quiet ride. As opposed to just the road noise coming through and coming into your cab, the road EQ will compensate.
Another key feature of the PXA-H800 is it has the ability to do true 5.1 sound. As you see here, it has all the right outputs to do it. Time delay is another important feature when you're trying to get proper sound staging in your vehicle. When you're the driver, unless you're in a McLaren F1, you sit different distances away from your tweeters. On your passenger side, this is going to be significantly further away from you compared to the driver's side tweeter or speaker. So what the sound processor allows to do with the use of the microphone is, it will do a time delay on the frequencies to make sure that your sound staging is correct. That way your ears hear the music coming from left to right at the same time.
Now that you have some info on the audio processor, let's talk about how you can control it with the RUX C800.
Now this unit is completely optional. You do not need to have this installed to control your audio processor. You can do everything without this, but this is a really nice finishing touch. As you see here, Alpine provides you with this nice little mounting piece, and it's extremely thin. So you can mount this pretty much anywhere in the dash that you want, and you know, you can graft it and you can have a nice flush look because this part right here is smaller than the actual bezel area. So you clear inside your dash or wherever you're going to mount it, put this on top, and it looks really trick, and it's super thin. So center consoles are no problem to put this unit in. Now, let's say that you want to make your ride look a little more trick, you got your full Alpine sound system in, this all matches, but the really nice thing is, It's hard to tune, honestly, for all types of music. It really is. So once you've done everything and you've had your bass line done, you might want to do some fine-tuning depending on the type of music that you're listening to. What this allows you to do is change your settings on the fly. So you're driving down, you're listening to your techno, your dubstep, you know, your electronic music, you have your setting for that. You want to listen to old-school rock, you have your setting for that. You want to listen to classical music, you have your setting for that. That's why you really want a piece like this. That way you're listening to your optimized music at all times. Well guys, I hope this gave you some more ideas on how you can really get your audio system up to the next level. If you have any more questions about this unit, you can check it out on the Alpine Canada website. Also, if you want to give me more feedback on what you want to see me do videos on, check out my website, gofasthavefun.ca. We'll be right back.